Hello, everyone. Happy Tuesday. It's time for another episode of Tuesday Live at 5. This is Lena Gersa. I'm an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator from Cambridge, Ontario, Canada. Gloomy and dark Cambridge, Ontario, Canada. And today I am hoping to bring a little sunshine, a little light and holiday cheer into your gloomy Tuesday with the Whimsy and Wonder Suite by Stampin' Up. Now, this suite is one that's in the holiday mini, and it is one that people either love or hate. We have lots of people who are traditionalists when it comes to their holiday color scheme, and it's got to be red and green all the way. Well, if that's you, you're probably not going to love these projects today because none of them follow a traditional red and green color scheme. That's because the colors in the beautiful specialty designer series paper in this suite are non-traditional. We have sort of a take on red and green. We've got kind of got a mint macaron and a blushing bride, but we certainly don't have a traditional red and green color scheme. But that's okay because it's fun to play with different color schemes. I don't know about you, but when I've been crafting Christmas cards for a long time, I am dying for something other than red and green. I get so sick of the same colors all the time. So I love this suite. I've been playing with it for quite a while, and I have three fun projects to show you today that really highlight the beautiful designer series paper in this suite. So I'm going to show you the paper, I'm going to show you the bundle, and then we will get busy making three projects, okay? Now, before we get to it, let me just pull up my video on my iPad here and see who is joining me. Let's see who's here. Hi, Penny. Hi, Grace. Hi, Krista. Hi, Jackie and Violet. Thanks so much for joining me. I'm so glad you could be here. I'm just trying to get this notification to go away. I don't know. There's some weird notification on my iPad. I don't know. Hi, Judy. Good to see you. I'm hoping it's nicer in Wawa than it is here. It's really gloomy. This time change, I hate this time change. I find it all the way from Australia. Glad you could join me, Jackie. I'm betting it's a whole lot nicer there than it is here. It's very gloomy here today. And with the time change that we just had this weekend, it is dark outside at 5 p.m., which is not fun. But anyway, we are going to spread a little sunshine and holiday cheer with some fun projects today. So I'm going to flip the camera, I'm going to stop talking, and we're going to get some stamping. Okay, so give me one sec. I need to get my lamp out of the way there. There we go. We got a little bit of a glare. See if we can do something about that. Straighten us out. There we go. I think we're good. All right, so as I mentioned, we are all about the Whimsy and Wonder Suite from the Holiday Mini. Now, this suite has lots of different components. I'm going to show the three that I'm going to focus on today. And that is, first of all, the bundle. We have the Whimsical Trees stamp set and Coordinating Christmas Trees dies. Now, I have to say, these coordinate really well, but if you can only get one, I would get the dies because they coordinate beautifully with the DSP. And you can do all kinds of cool things just with paper and the dies and not necessarily need the stamp set. Now, obviously, you want to get the bundle, but if you can only afford one, I would get this one. All right, so that is the bundle. And then, of course, we have this gorgeous specialty designer series paper. Now, every sheet has one side that has sort of this iridescent foil on it. And then the other side has some beautiful, slightly more muted patterns. So let me show you both sides. So this one has these gorgeous ornaments. I absolutely love this paper. I've actually been hoarding it a little bit. When I made the projects for today, it was the first time I actually cut into a piece of this paper because I love it so much. So I'm trying to take a page from my own little crafty Bible and practice what I preach. So I'm cutting this beautiful paper today. So we have beautiful ornaments on one side and then this lovely misty moonlight sort of tree pattern on the other. So that's one. And then we have this gorgeous stripe. And on the back, we've got, it almost looks like snow against a mossy meadow background. This pattern has these beautiful gifts. And then on the other side, this beautiful mossy meadow holly pattern. I'm not sure how well that shows up. I'll pull it a little closer so you can see it. It's a beautiful, just really subtle pattern. This one is one of my favorites as well, this holly pattern. So this one is the side that has the iridescent foiling, and then when we flip it over, we get this sort of knit look with the polished pink. Now, these two patterns I've used so much of, I don't have very much left. I don't have full sheets, but this is this gorgeous Christmas tree pattern. And then on the reverse side, we just sort of have a mint macaron sort of diamond pattern. I just realized that my power cable is not connected to my phone. Let's plug that in just to make sure we don't run out of juice while we're stamping today. And then finally, this beautiful, this is my absolute favorite pattern, is this snowflake. What is it? Blushing Bride snowflakes. So, so pretty. And then on the back, we have a stripe. So just gorgeous paper and so many possibilities with this paper. So today I'm really going to be highlighting the paper and the coordination with the dots. All right. So let's get to some stamping. Hi, Jill. Thanks for joining. Oh, beautiful sunny spring day in Sydney. I am so jealous, Jackie. I would love to be in the midst of a beautiful sunny spring day right about now, as we are looking square into 5 months of winter. All right, so this is our first project. I posted this one yesterday. Again, total focus on the DSP on this card. So we're using two different patterns, but this and this are the reverse of each other, right? So let's get to it. Pull out all my bits and bobs here. There are several. I don't wanna lose my little holly leaves here. We're gonna set those up there just so we don't lose them. All right, so to start, we have, again, a beautiful piece of that DSP. This is the pattern with the trees on one side, and then this really subtle sort of mint macaron pattern on the back. So this piece is 4 by 5 1/4. Then we have a 2 by 4 inch piece of that ornament paper, but I'm using the reverse side, the Misty Moonlight. So that's gonna layer on there like that. And then I have this stitched die cut rectangle that has been embossed with the star crossed embossing folder. See, I remember the name. Aren't you impressed? So that's going to become sort of our background for our focal image. Okay, so before we start assembling, let's put our die cut wreath onto our background here. So this is die cut using the Seasonal Swirls dies, one of my favorite new sets of dies in the holiday mini. And I have added some adhesive sheets on the back of this just to make it easier to stick down. When we have really intricate die cuts like this, trying to get glue onto these very fine die cuts can be a challenge. So using the adhesive sheets just makes your life so much better. So I'm gonna hide this part here that isn't really very full with my ornaments. So I'm just gonna go ahead and stick this down fairly in the middle-ish on there. Okay, just like that. Now we can go ahead and start building our background. Okay, oh, hi Lois, thanks for joining me today. All right, so we are going to add a little bit of adhesive to the back of our Misty Moonlight DSP. And it's gonna go on a little bit below center. So this is about 1 1/4 inches up from the bottom edge of my DSP piece here, okay? Now, this is a little on the long side, so we're just gonna trim that down right now. Take care of that. There we go. All right, now this is ready to go ahead and glue onto our background. Okay, just like that. So we're just gonna add a little bit of glue to the back of this guy. These projects today should be pretty quick and easy. At least that's what I'm hoping. We're gonna try not to screw up. It's been quite the week and it's only Tuesday. What can I say? All right, let's pop this one on. There we go. Okay, now that is going to get layered onto a piece of polished pink. And this is where we get the really unexpected color palette that is in this paper. The polished pink is not something you would expect to see in a Christmas pattern, but I absolutely love just the pop of surprise color that it provides. So we're gonna layer our DSP panel onto this piece of polished pink. Now I should mention, it is 4 1/8 by 5 3/8 inches. So 1/8 of an inch larger on both dimensions than my DSP panel, okay? All right, now before we add any more to our card, we're gonna put that onto our card base. So our card base is thick basic white cardstock. I like to use the thick basic white for card bases. It just gives a nice sturdy base. It's 4 1/4 by 11 inches, scored in the middle at 5 1/2. Hi, Martine. Thanks for joining me today. And then we're going to just burnish that, fold it in half along our score line. Add a little bit of adhesive to the back of our panel here. And we're going to pop that onto our card base, hopefully relatively straight. Okay. All right. Now I have some of these adorable whimsical ornaments that I fussy cut from the designer series paper. Now you may be thinking, oh, there's no way I could hand cut circles. Well, they're meant to be whimsical. They're not perfectly round. They look like they're watercolored, so they don't have a really defined edge. So if you are not great at fussy cutting circles, don't worry, because you don't have to be great. You just kind of follow the pattern on these ornaments. They're actually quite easy to fussy cut out. I'm just going to round that a little bit because there's a little bit of a burr there. All right, so we are going to arrange these sort of on the right side of our card. So I'm just going to take and add a dimensional to the back of the largest ornament. And I'm actually going to put a mini right up near the top just because we're going to add a bow to that in a little bit. So this guy's going to kind of go up here. Okay. And then we're going to add our little pink ornament. So we're just going to tuck a dimensional in right next to our green ornament and then just attach that, layer it just over top. And that way I don't have to worry about accidentally bumping over top of this one that's already popped. Same thing with the blue one. We're going to add a dimensional right there. And we're going to pop this guy on right about there. So easy, right? I actually sat and fussy cut a whole bunch of these ornaments out. It didn't take me long at all. I was actually watching the hockey game. Well, I was listening to the hockey game as I was fussy cutting. And I like to do that because then I just have a stash of them and can use them on projects really easily. All right. Now our sentiment is going to be stamped on this polished pink stitched rectangle. And we're going to use the Let Your Heart Be Light sentiment from the Whimsical Tree set. And I'm going to stamp it in the Misty Moonlight. Okay. Oh, hi, Karen. Glad you're here. Thank you. Hi, Colleen. All right. So I am going to attempt to stamp this straight and centered on this very little bitty die cut while not actually looking straight down. We're going to see what happens. Oh, that's better than I thought it would be. I actually cut it back up just in case I screwed it up. It's very hard to stamp when you're not looking straight down on your work. All right, so that is going to get layered right across sort of the bottom of our wreath here. So we're going to add a couple of dimensionals. Now I'm not gonna put one right at the edge because it's going to overlap our ornaments a little bit. So we'll do that and then add just a touch of tape there so they stick down onto the ornaments that are popped. So we're just going to put that right about there. Hopefully straight. Let's straighten that out a bit. There we go. Okay. And then I have three little bitty holly leaves. These are actually die cut using the same die set that I use for the wreath. They're the seasonal swirls. And I've cut them from Mint Macaron and a little bit of Just Jade. I wanted a little bit of contrast on one of my leaves. So it actually, the Just Jade works perfectly. And I loved it so much, I actually used it on another project that we're going to do in a couple of minutes. The combination of Just Jade. Oh, now these are really big glue dots. I'm going to see if we can roll that. Make it a little bit smaller so we can fit it behind our leaf. The Just Jade and Mint Macaron are a gorgeous complementary color combination for greens. So there is our Just Jade leaf. Now these guys actually have adhesive sheets on them because I sort of threw the dies on there as I was cutting the wreath out. So these have adhesive already, which makes it super easy. We're just going to peel off our backing and layer on one and two. I should be using my take your pick to peel these off. But the thumbnail will do for today. And then we're gonna add our second one here. So we have our little cluster of holly leaves. And then to create our berry, we're actually gonna use some of the In Color gems. Now these are in the annual catalog. And because I've got the polished pink in my color scheme, I thought these would work really nicely. So I'm gonna use one large one for my holly berry here. Oh, I'm losing my tip here. And then we're just gonna add a couple more around our wreath here just to kind of balance it out and just add a little extra bling. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, And again, our eye always likes odd numbers, right? So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. You like that one? Now on the inside of this one, I kept it super simple. I just had a leftover strip of the DSP, which I added on the inside and then stamped a sentiment. Super simple. Oh, we forgot our bow. How could we forget our bow? And this, I don't know how I could forget my bow. It's not possible. So this twine is actually also in the annual. It's from the Flowers for Every Season combo pack. It's got Misty Moonlight and white and silver, which is perfect for my color scheme on this card. So we're just going to tie ourselves a cute little bow here. Make our loops fairly small. We don't want it to overpower our ornament. And then we're going to take a glue dot, roll it into a little glue booger here. And I'm just going to press it at the top of my green ornament here. And then we'll trim our bow off of our roll. Press that into place. Now my tails are a little long, so let's just see if we can tidy those up a little bit. And there we go. That one's still a bit long. There we go. Give them a little haircut and we're good to go. All right. You like that one? I think it's super quick and easy and cute. Cute is fun. Thank you, Karen. Yes, I know, Louise and Krista, you guys are here to remind me when I'm making mistakes and forget bows. Thank you. All right. Next card is this one. So I mentioned that I really love the combination of Just Jade and Mint Macaron together. And so I used it on this card. So we have the Just Jade, the Mint Macaron, and some Blushing Bride. And then these trees, believe it or not, are die cut from the DSP. So I have to show you a really cool discovery that I made. Stampin Up does this a lot, and I don't know why I was surprised to discover this, but I just hadn't noticed it before. So it kind of made my day when I discovered. So here is some of that DSP, and here are the dies. So this die cuts out that tree. This die cuts out that tree. And this chubby little tree actually cuts out two different trees on here. This one and this one. How cute is that? So once I discovered that, of course, I had to make a project using the die cut trees from the DSP. So that's how I ended up with this one. All right. So again, super quick and easy. The only stamping on this is our sentiment. So let's get to it. We'll pull out all our bits here and put this guy together. Lickety split. All right. So to start, I have some of that gorgeous snowflake pattern DSP. It is 2.5 by 5.25. And then I have a piece of Mint Macaron cardstock that is, I think, 2 5/8. Yes, 2 5/8 by 5.25. So I'm going to layer my DSP onto my cardstock, and I'm going to have just a little hint of the Mint Macaron peeking out on either side. So I'll just throw a little bit of adhesive on there. Hi, Mavis. Hi, Giselle. Hello, Susan. Thank you for joining me. All right, let's pop this guy on. Okay, and again, we got a little overhang. I don't know who measured these and cut them, but clearly they're really, really not very good at measuring. It was me. I'll confess, it was me. All right, so there is my DSP that's layered. Now here I have a piece of Just Jade cardstock. It's 4 by 5.25 inches, and it's embossed using the Tasteful Textile embossing folder. Love that folder for really subtle texture. It just kind of elevates your project just ever so slightly because it just adds some subtle texture. So we are going to adhere our layered DSP to that piece of cardstock centered going down the middle. Okay, so I have an equal stripe sort of on either side. So again, we'll add a little bit of adhesive. Now, if you're new to my videos, you will discover a couple of things about me. One is I love layers. Two is I love, sorry, I can't talk and stamp at the same time. I gotta pause while I stick this or I'll stick it crooked. That's another thing you'll discover about me. I can't talk and craft at the same time. I love bling. I love bows. And I'm a little bit addicted to dimensionals. All right. So there you go. That's all you need to know about me and my videos. All right. So that is our background panel. Now we're going to go ahead and glue that onto our card base. So just like the last card, we have, oh yeah, it is a great embossing folder, Claire. I will agree. It's a great embodying folder too.
Gotta love autocorrect. Just like our last card, this piece is 4 1/4 by 11 inches, scored in the middle at 5 1/2. Now this is mint macaron. I'm not sure if I mentioned that. So we've got two shades of green going on this card that just work beautifully together. So we kind of have red and green, right? We've got pink, which is a shade of red, and we've got two shades of green. So this is almost a traditional Christmas card, right? I'm trying to convince all of the non-traditionalists with us that, you know, it's okay to deviate from the norm sometimes. All right, so there is our card base. Okay, now we're going to decorate. So the first thing we're going to do is stamp our sentiment. So this little label is die cut using the seasonal labels dies. I've cut it from Mint Macaron cardstock. And I'm going to stamp a sentiment from the Whimsical Tree stamp set using just jade ink. So again, these colors just work so beautifully together. Now I'm going to just do a test run. Oh, that's pretty straight. Okay. Sometimes I'm not so good at mounting my stamps straight. And even though I stamp them, it looks like they're straight when I'm stamping them, they end up crooked. So sometimes it's good to do a little test run. So there is our label. Now I have here one of the beautiful laser cut, wonderful snowflakes that are also part of this suite. These come in packs of 24. I think they're like $8.95 or $8.50 or something here in Canada, which is a great deal. They're super detailed, and the best part is you don't have to die cut them. They come already cut. You just pop them out and they're ready to go. Now, if I stick this down here, you're gonna see that most of my snowflake is covered, and I didn't really like that. So I'm just gonna make it bigger. So all I'm going to do is cut my snowflake in half. I'm going to go ahead and add a little bit of adhesive to the back of my label. And then we're going to stick half a snowflake at the top. And make sure I've got my shiny side up here. Half a snowflake at the bottom. And suddenly we have a bigger snowflake. Okay, really easy way to increase the size of these. So that is going to get adhered to the front of our card using a couple of dimensionals. So we'll just throw a couple of these guys on here. Pull off our backings. Oh, this DSP, Karen, if you only get one thing from this product suite, get the DSP. It's so gorgeous. Now, I know I'm not supposed to be enabling all you DSP hoarders, but honestly, it's beautiful. All right, so now we have our three trees that we die cut from the DSP using our dies. So this large one is kind of going to tuck in behind our label here. Okay, it's going to get stuck flat onto the front of our card. So we'll use a little bit of liquid glue just so we can kind of maneuver it into place. Yeah, well, sometimes we need bigger snowflakes, right? So you just pretend that it's bigger. You just let it out a little. Just like when you have pants that are too big, you let them out a little. That's what we're doing. All right, so there is our large tree. Now these guys, these smaller guys, are going to get popped up. Okay, so this one is going to overlap our label ever so slightly. And we're going to add a couple of dimensionals. Let's get full size ones here. To the bottom part, and I'm going to add just a touch of tape to the top so that where it overlaps the label, it sticks flat. So again, this one, we want to offset our trees a little bit. So it's going to go on right about there. Okay, and then our chubby little tree is going to go down here. I'm going to maybe move them over just a bit. So again, we're going to add a large dimensional, and we'll add a mini just so he stays popped. So we'll pop that guy on. Right about there. And there's our little cluster of trees. Isn't that cute? All right, now we need a bow because, well, we do. And every card looks better with a bow, if you ask me. So this is some of that gorgeous white glittered organdy ribbon. It has to be my favorite new ribbon from the holiday catalog. It can be colored any color using our Stampin' Blends, but we're going to use white on this project. So we're just going to quick tie a cute little bunny ear bow here. Pull our loops nice and tight. And then the thing with bows is you kind of have to tease the bow out. So for those of you that say you're awful bow tires, sometimes it's because you don't play with it enough to get a pretty bow out of it. Nobody's bow looks great when they first tie it. You have to convince the ribbon to be pretty. Okay. So then we're going to trim our tails at a bit of an angle here. Get this out of the way. And then this cute little bow is just going to tuck into the bottom corner of our label. Find my glue dots. So we'll just take and press the knot of our bow into a glue dot, a very large glue dot. This is my pack of glue dots that's kind of an oddball. It's very, very large. Not sure why. All right, and then the last touch is to add just a little more sparkle. Now these self-adhesive rhinestones, what are these? Sequins. They are from the ephemera, Artistry and Ink ephemera pack from the annual catalog. And they have that iridescent quality with that sort of pink overtone that works perfectly on this card. So we're just gonna add a couple of these, three to be exact, because our eye likes threes and our eye likes triangles. So we made a little triangle of three little sequins. Okay. Now on the inside of this one, I just stamped some more trees. Now I'm actually gonna, I didn't mount those trees. I'll explain what I did here. On this one, I stamped the large tree in mint macaron. This guy is in just jade. And then this guy, I actually stamped twice. So I stamped it once in just jade, and then I kind of re-inked and just sort of stamped right over top. Now, normally it would look pretty bad, but because of the sort of scribbly nature of this tree, it actually fills it in. And I did that so that you couldn't see this tree sort of coming through the image of this tree. Okay, so by double stamping that, it actually makes it a little bit fuller and it gives you sort of a little bit of an illusion of depth. Okay, and then of course we added a sentiment from the stamp set and we're good to go. Super quick and easy card. Made extra easy by the fabulous DSP. All right, now we're gonna do a fun fold. I gotta make some room here because I'm gonna have to bring my trimmer in. So let me just clean up my mess here a bit. Get all these bits and bobs out of the way. Okay. So this project is one I posted earlier today, and it is a simple collar fold card. However, I've turned it into a gift card holder with just the addition of an extra strip of designer series paper. Okay, and I thought this was a almost perfect color, this Starbucks gift card, for my project. So I'm going to show you how to make this. It is so, so easy, and it's a great way to use up DSP. Oh, I've got a rogue sequin here. So when you are, you know, feeling guilty about buying more DSP, this is a great way to make yourself feel better because you will use almost a half sheet on this project. So let me show you how to do it. Okay. We're going to start with a piece of this beautiful, see, I told you I cut this gorgeous DSP. Now I didn't cut it into a small piece. I had to make a project that featured it so that I could showcase how beautiful these ornaments are, but I still cut it. So be proud. All right. So this is 12 by 4 3/4. Okay, so 12 inches long by 4 3/4. If you are using directionally specific DSP like this is, okay, meaning my ornaments need to kind of go up and down, right? I'm going to make sure that when I am scoring my first score line, that I have my ornaments going, the tops of my ornaments going to the left, okay? Gotta move my little basket of goodies there. So I'm going to put my DSP into my trimmer. I'm actually using the ruler on the right side of the cutting track. I find that easier when I'm doing really narrow score lines. So I'm going to put it into the half inch mark on the right side of my cutting track and I'm going to score. So again, I'm making sure that if I have directionally specific DSP that the top is to the left for this first step. Okay, that's really important or your DSP will be upside down. Okay, so we're just going to go ahead and score that. Now, it's not going to show up really well here, but if I turn it over, you can see that score line. You see that? All right, so now I'm going to turn it so I have my 12-inch side at the top. I'm going to open up my arm here. Again, too much stuff on my desk. There's a reason I don't use the trimmer very often in videos. I don't have a lot of space here. All right, so I'm going to put, now my DSP is right side up. Okay, I'm going to put the left side of my paper in at 3 1/4 inches. And I'm going to score. Okay, then I'm going to slide over to 8 3/4. So we're going all the way over to 8 3/4 inches. And we're going to score again. Okay, let me show you those lines. Okay, so now we kind of have a large panel in the middle and then two smaller panels on either side. Okay, you can see that. All right, the last thing we need to do, I'm going to bring this arm back in just to give myself more space. I'm going to line up the left edge. Again, I'm right side up. Okay, so my pattern is right side up. And I'm going to put my paper in right so that it butts up against the ridge here. That's the 6-inch mark. Okay, I'm going to move my cutting blade all the way to the top, and I need to cut down to 1 3/4 inches. So there is a ruler. If you have one of our Stampin' Up! Paper trimmers, there is a ruler on your blade guide. Okay, so we're going to cut down to there. Now, if you don't have a ruler on your blade guide, you can measure first and mark it with a pencil so that you know how far down to cut. Okay, so I'm going to cut down to 1 3/4 and try to see where 1 3/4 is. Okay, so right about there. So now I have my little slit here. Okay, that's all the cutting and scoring for this one. So we'll get this out of the way. Now we are going to need our paper snips. Before we do anything, I'm going to go ahead and fold along these score lines just so that you can see them a little bit easier. Normally I wouldn't do this, but it is really hard to see the score lines on a video. I'm aware of that. So we'll just fold these so you can kind of see what I'm doing. Make it a little bit easier to kind of keep track of what's going on. So I'm folding my score lines. Okay, so what I'm going to do on each of these two little side flaps, I'm actually going to cut this piece off. So I'm going to cut up from the bottom to that horizontal half inch score line. And when I cut this piece off, I'm actually going to cut a little bit above the score line, and I'm going to bevel it a little bit. So I'm going to kind of cut at an angle. You might naturally cut an angle if you have a crooked eye like me. You don't have to work too hard to cut crooked. Okay, so you can see that that is not straight. Okay, we're going to do the same thing on the other side. So I'm going to cut up from the bottom. And then again, I'm going to cut a little bit above that score line and cut down to get rid of that flap. Okay, all right, let's get rid of these guys. Now we're ready to assemble. So these two flaps are going to fold inwards. I'm just going to burnish them a little bit more so they're nice and flat. And then our bottom flap is going to fold upwards. Now, one thing that I do like to do on my bottom flap as well is just angle these a little bit just so they look a little bit tidier. Kind of like an envelope, you know, when you have a little bit of a bevel on your envelope flaps. I just think it looks a little bit tidier. That's totally optional, not required. So our two flaps are going to get glued flat. So I'm going to put a little bit of adhesive along one side of my flap and just fold that over. Okay, and then we're going to add some adhesive along this half inch flap at the bottom and fold that up. And there we go. There's our little pocket. Okay, now this next step, this we're going to turn this over. That's the back where the seams are. This is the front. And now we need to create our collar. So the easiest way to do that is to take a ruler or some other straight edge, and we're going to line up our ruler right at the base of the slit and line it up so it's right at the corner of our fold there. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of get that. That's going to give us the correct angle to start our crease. So I'm just going to kind of start that way, take away my ruler, and then burnish it so it's nice and flat. Okay, same thing on this side. So again, I'm going to just place my ruler here, start my fold. My husband just came home. He's banging around upstairs. I'm not sure if you can hear it. I apologize if it's loud. All right, so there is my little collar. Okay, so we're just going to add a dimensional under each point just so that it pops up ever so slightly. You could even curl it a little bit if you wanted to. Maybe we'll do that just for the heck of it. Just to give it a little bit of dimension and highlight the fact that that is a little collar look. So you just kind of curl it a little bit so it's not laying perfectly flat. And that is our pocket. So easy, right? All right, now to put the rest of this card together, where did I put my other pieces? There they are. I've already gone ahead and done some stamping and heat embossing just in the interest of time. So our insert here is a super simple panel. So we start out with a piece of basic white cardstock. It's 4 1/4. Yes, Karen, I agree. It does remind me of vintage ornaments. Maybe that's why I love it so much. 5 1/4 by 4 inches, basic white. And then I've stamped and heat embossed some of the ornaments from the Whimsical Tree stamp set in silver. Okay, now before we glue that, we're going to color a little bit. So I'm using some Stampin' Blends. Let me just look at my original so I remember what I did. It's been a while. So I'm going to color this sort of long, skinny ornament with my light Flirty Flamingo. I wanted it really, really soft and subtle. Now, Flirty Flamingo is not in the color palette of this DSP. However, Blushing Bride is. Now, we don't have a Blushing Bride Blends marker, So the light Fleur de Flamingo is pretty darn close. Okay. And then I'm going to color just this little sort of decoration in the center of the ornament using my light polished pink blends. Okay, so that's that guy. Then this sort of longer ornament here at the bottom, we're going to color using our light misty moonlight. So we'll just add, and the nice thing about coloring when you've heat embossed is if you happen to go outside the lines a little bit, you don't really notice because the embossing kind of disguises or camouflages, that's the word I'm looking for, camouflages our little oopsies. So heat embossing makes your coloring look that much better. All right, and then we're gonna color just the stripe across the middle again with our polished pink. So a little bit of that. And then our last ornament is going to be colored using our light mint macaron. And I forgot to bring my dark over to do the little stripe in the middle. So maybe we'll just leave it silver for now. So we're just going to add a little bit of color to this guy. So the nice thing about this particular project is you actually see the top of your inside panel. So it's always fun to kind of decorate that top edge like I did here so that it has a little bit of visual interest. And then my little ornament hangers, I'm just going to color with my light smoky slate, which is very close to silver. This doesn't have the sparkle of silver. So I'll just add a quick little bit of this. These are super quick and easy to color, these guys. All right, so there we go. Now that is going to get adhered to a piece of Misty Moonlight cardstock. It is 5 3/8 by 4 1/8. Okay, so we're just gonna have a narrow little border. Now before we do that, we are going to adhere our DSP strip to make our pocket for our gift card holder. So this is just 1 1/4 by 5 1/4 inches. Again, I've used that same coordinating DSP that I used on the front, or for my pocket, I should say. So we're going to add a little bit of adhesive. Now we wanna take care not to go too high up from the bottom with our adhesive because we still need to have a pocket, right? So I'm just kind of going right along the bottom edge and the sides to create my little pocket. We're gonna stick this down on our white panel here, and that will give us our pocket. Okay, so my gift card will tuck in just like that. All right, now we're ready to go ahead. Oh, I almost forgot. We need a little bit of this ribbon to make our little pull tab. So again, if you have little bitty scraps of ribbon, making little pull tabs for your pocket cards is a great use of it. So if you are like me and you hate to waste stuff, this is the way to do it. All right, so we're just gonna take and press a glue dot onto that little scrap of white to make a little loop. And then I'm gonna add another glue dot. And we are gonna stick this down, hopefully in the middle-ish. Come on. Work with my glue dots, there we go. So we're gonna stick this down about in the middle of our little ornament panel here. So this is 5 1/4. So 2 5/8-ish is about the middle. So I'm just using the ruler on my grid paper so I know where that is approximately. And then we're gonna go ahead and glue this onto our Misty Moonlight panel. So I'll just add a little bit of tape here. That's really, Karen, that's crazy. Facebook's a little bit behind. I've been live forever now. I'm glad you found me when you did. You would have missed a bunch. All right, so there's my little pull tab. Okay, now we're gonna stamp a sentiment on our white circles. These are just die cut using the layering circles dies. And again, this is another sentiment from the Whimsical Tree set. I'm stamping it in Misty Moonlight ink. So we'll just stamp it centered on our little circle there. And then we're going to layer that on a Misty Moonlight circle. As soon as I find my liquid glue. Everything's all kind of over the place on this desk right now because I had to make room for my trimmer. All right, so there is our circle. Now, this is an important step. Don't screw this up. When that's as much for me as for anybody. When we glue this down, we're not going to put glue all over the back of this circle, right? Because if we stick it down, we're not going to have a pocket. So we are only going to put glue on the bottom half of our circle. So like kind of right there, right? So that we don't stick our pocket shut. So again, we're just gonna kind of eyeball this so it's kind of centered, lined up with our little loop. And there we go, we still have a pocket. Okay, so there is our panel. We're gonna tuck that inside our card. All right, and now we're gonna add a little bit of a focal image to our pocket as soon as I find what I did with my little label. Where did it go? Where has my label gone? Maybe I forgot to cut one. All right, so we have this cute little label here. I'm gonna just cut one right now because my punch is right here. So we're using the Label Me Lovely punch, and I'm gonna grab a little bit of that DSP. It is our trees pattern. So we're just gonna pop a little label out of that DSP. Now normally I wouldn't punch it out of a nice sheet like this. I would use scrap, but that's okay. I'll make the sacrifice for you guys. So there is my little label. And then we're gonna go ahead and arrange our ornaments. There it is. It was upside down. See what I mean? My goodness, you guys. All right, that's all right. Took one for the team there. So we have our three ornaments here. Okay, they're gonna kind of get arranged like that on our label. Now, on the DSP pattern, on the ornament DSP, you can see it. There's all kinds of these little bows. And I thought, how cute would it be to add a little bow to one of our ornaments? So I cut one out. And we're gonna do that. So I'm just gonna roll this guy up. Come on. And I can't wait till I'm done this roll of glue dots. They're so big. I don't know what happened. That's not normal. So we're gonna add a little bow there, okay? And then these guys are all gonna get arranged and popped up with some dimensionals. So we're gonna start with this bigger guy. And they're gonna go on to our little label. Kind of right there. Okay, then we'll add our little green one over here. So again, I mentioned I fussy cut a whole bunch of these out of the DSP the other night, and it's really fun to just kind of play with these little bits. It makes cards come together really quickly. Okay, and then this guy is going to kind of go in the center, but before we put that on, we have this cute little joy sentiment. This is also from the Whimsical Tree stamp set. So we're going to glue that with a dimensional right over top of the flowers in the center of an ornament. And I kind of like the way they sort of frame the sentiment there. And then we're going to add a dimensional here and a little bit of tape to the back of our ornament. And we'll just kind of pop that on, hopefully straight. There we go. So there's our little focal image. And then that is going to kind of go right at the sort of point of our collar here. So we're going to add a couple of dimensionals. So again, my best tip with this is to put your dimensionals directly on your pocket, just to make sure that you don't stick your pocket closed. Okay, I almost did it. I didn't. I caught myself, but I almost did. So that's my best advice for you. Okay, so then that is going to go on right about there. Okay, and then our last little touch again is one of our pretty, pretty glittered organdy bows. So we'll tie another quick bow and make it pretty. Play around with our loops. I'm glad I'm not the only one, Claire. Honestly, I was saying to my team last night, if there's a mistake to be made, I have made it, which means I probably have a solution. It's very rare that I have to actually throw something out that I screw up on. Usually I can find a way to hide my boo-boo or make it part of the design. Sometimes we have to embrace our flaws, right? All right, that one's still a little long. Let's trim that just a bit more. All right, now that is going to go just at the top of our large ornament there. So once again, I'm gonna take one of these massive glue dots, press the knot of my bow into the dot, and then just stick her down. There we go. Okay, isn't that cute? Super quick and easy way to whip up a gift card holder. I don't know about you, but I tend to give a lot of gift cards at this time of year, especially now as, you know, my niece and nephew were getting older, and my husband is so hard to buy for, and my son now, he loves gift cards, so I tend to give a lot of them at this time of year, and I love having fun packaging. Now, this will still fit into a standard envelope, okay? So even if you wanted to mail it, if you had to send a gift long distance, that's an easy way to do it, okay? So let me bring back all of our projects. So we've got one, two, and three. There we go. Such a mess here. It's a good thing your eyes can't see the rest of this room. All right, there are our projects. I hope you like those. Check out this suite, especially check out the DSP. Honestly, if there's one thing that you get from the suite, it should be the DSP because it's fabulous. All right. Okay, everybody. Thanks for joining me tonight. Have an awesome week, and I will see you again next week for another episode of Tuesday Live at 5. Bye for now.